Students, in the previous topic, we have discussed the various conventional methods such as rooting, grafting, layering, and types. Now, we are going to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of these conventional methods. Advantages: the plants produced are genetically identical, so they will have a genetic identity with their parent. Many plants can be produced quickly. So if you want to produce thousands and thousands of numbers of plants, we can produce in a large scale cultivation. Some of the plants produce little or no seeds. In others, do not germinate. In these cases, conventional methods can be used. So in which plants there is no production of seeds, or the seeds are very less, or the seeds are not germinating, in these cases the conventional methods can be applied. Some plants can be propagated more economically. So which plants are more economically valuable and where there is a food scarcity at the time to fulfill the food need, a particular plant which is needed to fulfill the food need can be multiplied more. For example, Solanum tuberosum potato. Two different plants with a desired character such as disease resistant and high yield can be propagated by grafting and grown as a new plant. So we can bind two beneficial characters such as disease resistant as well as high yield. Both character, beneficial character, we can bring in a single plant. Disadvantages: use of viral infected plants as parents produces viral infected plants. When the mother plant is infected with the virus, the young ones also will have the same viral infection. That is the drawback. As vegetative propagules are so bulky, difficult to handle and store, the vegetative propagules such as rhizomes are so bulky, so very difficult to handle and store them.